Welcome to WFMJ Weekend Today. I'm Lindsay McCoy. We are following breaking news this morning out of Youngstown, where police are on the scene of a deadly shooting at the Brothers of Power Car Club. Thank you so much for that. Great information. I'm on the other side of the room. We're going to turn out of finances. Late last night, the president signed legislation called the Families First Coronavirus Response Act. Here's a snapshot of what that bill looks like. It provides free coronavirus testing. It ensures paid emergency leave for those who are infected or caring for a family member with an illness. It provides additional Medicaid funding, food assistance, and unemployment benefits. We have a busy show with some big names, but first, we do have to get to the latest numbers out of Ohio and across our country as the rapidly spreading coronavirus outbreak is responsible for more deaths. Here are the latest headlines coming up. Ohio and Pennsylvania see a rise in cases, with more at the local level. Trumbull County declares a state of emergency, hoping to tap into some funding, and a possible vote coming on a stimulus bill that could reach $2 trillion. A lot to cover over the next hour. And ahead on Press Pass, Congress scrambling to pass that coronavirus-related stimulus package. We're talking with Congressman Mike Kelly about the efforts to help Americans through this outbreak and the status of our economy as we know it. But first, since we are really limited to where we can go, outside might be a decent option. Chief Meteorologist Eric Wilhelm joining us this morning, tracking what we have in store for our forecast. Good morning to you. Trumbull County commissioners declare a state of emergency over the coronavirus outbreak. This formal designation allows the county to tap into some emergency funding. Trumbull County Commissioner Frank Fuda there, he says more funds are desperately needed to cover the cost of personal protective equipment for those who are on the front lines of this pandemic. Nearly 80 million Americans will be under mandatory lockdown orders by the end of this weekend. New Jersey joining the list of states telling people to not leave their homes as the nation struggles to slow the spread of the virus. NBC's Chris Pallone has the latest this morning. Overseas, Italy reported its worst day fighting the coronavirus with about 800 deaths in just 24 hours. However, the epicenter of the outbreak in Wuhan, China, has gone 3 days without a newly reported case. The city must go 2 straight weeks without a new one in order to certain travel restrictions be lifted. In more local news now, Warren police detectives are investigating a homicide in the city. It happened Wednesday after police pulled over a driver and found that his passenger, 26-year-old Mark Dixon Jr., had multiple gunshot wounds. He was taken to a hospital where he later passed away. An investigation is ongoing. The Valley is reacting after learning about the sudden death of State Representative Don Manning. Manning died from a heart attack Friday night. The Republican from New Middletown was serving his first term in the Ohio House. Lawmakers from both sides of the aisle say Manning was in politics for the right reasons, and he was passionate about this valley. WFMJ is pleased to announce a project premiering this morning, which will enable local places of worship to stream their weekly services. A lot of you may already do this, but viewers should look for that streaming link banner on WFMJ.com or our 21 News app. This weekend, we're going to launch with services now underway as of this hour from St. Rose and St. Christine, and at 10:30 this morning will be St. Columba Cathedral. We'll have a streaming service from there. Now, the streaming of local churches and their services is brought to you by 898 Marketing, Drund, and 21 WFMJ. If you want your place of worship included, just please click on the streaming page, as all denominations are welcome and more services will be added for next weekend and beyond, something that you can definitely take in at home when you're with your family. You know, a brand new business that brought crowds of people to Boardman, Liberty, and Warren is closing its doors until further notice. But no more in-person diving for deals. Bon Voyage's founder announcing on Facebook that it is closing its locations in response to the coronavirus. The company is a discount bin store that sells items from major retailers for a fraction of the cost. Bon Voyage will have more information about its online auctions that are coming up sometime today. Yeah, so many closures and cancellations. That is why we have them all in one spot for you over on WFMJ.com and our 21 News app, as things are always changing. Another thing changing, our forecast. It looks like spring is starting to make its way here, Eric. And you say that we can enjoy the outdoors a little bit today and maybe during the week.
Yeah, certainly.
A chilly start, but hey, we have a beautiful sunrise. Welcome back. 9:30 here on your Sunday morning, and we are back with more news now. The top four members of Congress will meet for a White House negotiator meeting this morning to try and finalize finalize a coronavirus-related stimulus package. Treasury Secretary Steve Mnuchin is negotiating on behalf of President Trump. He will meet with Senator Mitch McConnell and Representative Kevin McCarthy, as well as State Minority Leader Chuck Schumer and House Speaker Nancy Pelosi. Senators hope to take a procedural vote on the package later this afternoon, and right now it is not clear if the House will support the plan from the upper chamber. The package could be worth $2 trillion. Work is underway to produce vital medical supplies and potential drugs to treat coronavirus. While the president suggested he could legally order companies to produce those supplies, he has not yet. NBC's Kelly O'Donnell has more. White House officials confirmed that Vice President Mike Pence and the Second Lady both tested negative for the coronavirus. Both were tested after a member of Pence's staff tested positive for the virus Friday night. The Vice President and Second Lady said they felt fine, but they were tested out of an abundance of caution. President Trump also tested negative for the virus last week. Now, coming up after this show on Meet the Press, America shuts down. Chuck Todd interviews members of the administration about their response to the outbreak and governors about what they're still missing. That is coming up at 10:30 right after this show. This Sunday on Press Pass, America's response to the coronavirus outbreak. The president is preparing the Defense Production Act, allowing the government to call on private industry to speed up the production of critical medical equipment. Meanwhile, Congress is hoping to provide Americans with some relief, passing a few multi-billion dollar emergency aid bills, and they're now working on a stimulus package. Here to weigh in on the latest developments, Congressman Mike Kelly from Pennsylvania. Congressman, thank you so much for coming in. A vote is expected to take place possibly as early as tomorrow on this $2 trillion spending bill. Do you expect that that will pass? And do you know the amounts? You say that you've heard things floated around, but you're not sure exactly how much working families would get.
Yeah, I think we really have to find out what the exact language is.
Confusion at the polls this past week when Ohio Governor Mike DeWine postponed the state's primary election over coronavirus concerns. You know, not long after that, a Franklin County judge rejected the proposal to delay the election. In the end, Ohio Department of Health Director Dr. Amy Acton had the final say, ordering the polls closed, citing a health emergency. A lot to cover as we head toward now a June primary date. Joining me this morning to weigh in, Ohio Secretary of State Frank LaRose. Frank, thank you so much for coming in.
Good morning, Lindsay.
Good morning. You know, you say you acted legally when you reset the Ohio primary to June 2nd. Still, the Ohio Democratic Party, they filed a lawsuit citing that only lawmakers can make that decision. They were citing federal law. Yeah. Does health and the CDC, Amy Acton, does that supersede the law in this case because of a pandemic?
This small valley next to the golf course was within the storm's path, snapping down trees. This one completely uprooted from the ground.
Mercy Health is screening patients as they come in here. You can see the yellow tent that is set up outside behind me.
All dining inside restaurants is off the menu. Carry out is not. And some of these local restaurants are going to start offering special menus with family-style packages for takeout.
Derek and Leslie, I spoke with workers as they left this plant's parking lot for what could be their very last time. They tell me workers inside were in tears today and emotional. The UAW says it plans to fight and continue to fight to bring another product to this plant, and they hope the message that they gathered here to send today makes it all the way to Detroit.